This video series is to accompany the Cisco Netacad Switching, Routing, and Wireless Essentials course. This video is Module 16, Troubleshooting, Static, and Default Routes. We're going to have two objectives in this video, packet processing with static routes, and troubleshooting an IPv4 static and default route configuration. 16.1, Packet Processing with Static Routes. PC1 addresses a packet to PC3 and it sends it to the default gateway address. So PC1 is trying to get to PC3. And when the packet arrives on the router 1 G000 interface, R1 decapsulates the packet and searches the routing table for a matching destination network entry. If the destination IP address matches a static route entry, Router 1 will use the static route to identify the next hop IP address or exit interface. If it does not match a specific route to the destination network, the Router 1 will then use the default static route if it's configured. And then if it does not match a route table entry, the R1 will drop the packet and send an ICMP message back to the source. And I would recommend that you could set this up on Packet Tracer and test these yourself. And you probably have done something very similar to this with Packet Tracer labs already, but you can set this one up fairly easily on your Packet Tracer and work with it. Now, assuming that Router 1 matched a routing table entry, it encapsulates the packet in a new frame and forwards it out the interface of S010 comes in and then forwards it out S010 to router 2. Here to router 2. It decapsulates and processes the packet the same way R1 did. And then when R2 finds a match in the routing table, it uses the identified next hop address or exit interface and sends the packet out its S011 and sends it down to R3. When R3 receives the packet, it decapsulates it and searches the routing table for a match. The destination IP address of PC3 does match in this case because it's directly connected to G, and you can't see it here, but the packet's overlaying it, but that's the G000. So R3 searches the ARP table for the layer 2 MAC address of PC3. If no ARP table entry exists, then router 3 sends an ARP request out that interface to look for the ARP information. PC then responds with an ARP reply containing its MAC address information. R3 then encapsulates the packet in a new frame, uses the PC3 MAC address as the destination MAC, and then out through the G00 MAC address as the source MAC address, and then the frame is forwarded out of the interface of G00, and PC3 receives it and processes the frame accordingly. 16.2, Troubleshooting IPv4, Static and Default Route Configuration. Now, networks do fail for a number of reasons. You can have an interface fail, a service provider drops a connection, links can become oversaturated, or an admin may enter a wrong configuration. So network administrators are responsible for pinpointing and problem solving what's going on with the network. So to efficiently find and solve these issues, it's advantageous to be familiar with the tools to help isolate routing problems quickly. So let's take a look at the chart on the next slide. You have the ping command. You can verify your layer 3 connectivity to destination. You can look for extended pings. They provide additional options. My recommendation, if you haven't already learned this, is if you are on the PC, you want to ping your local network card of 127.0.0.1. Then you want to ping your default gateway, and then you want to ping an IP address outside the default gateway to see if your default gateway is forwarding and sending back ping packets. You can also use the trace route command that verifies the path. It uses ICMP echo reply messages to determine the hops. You can also, on your routers or switches, use the show IP route that displays your routing table. You can show IP interface brief that displays the status of your device interfaces. Or you can show CDP neighbors that displays a list of directly connected Cisco devices. And it also is used to validate layer 1 and layer 2 connectivity. So connectivity from PC1 to PC3 fails. So if we have a failure, we can use extended pings from R1. And if extended pings from R1 interface to PC3 fail, pings from R1 to R2 are successful. Pings from R1 to R3 are successful. So R2, the routing table, reveals the problem and the incorrect static route is removed. And a new static route solves the problem. And we can see that in the show IP route on the right-hand side here. And finally, what did you learn in this module? You can pause your video here if you want to read down through these. This is screen one. We have screen two here. You can pause your video. And finally, we have another screen with the table of the ping, traceroute, show IP route, show IP interface brief, and show CDP neighbors detail. I hope these videos were helpful for you. And if you have any questions, you can leave a comment below, or you can email me, and you can find that on my YouTube channel. Hope you have a great day, and remember, be excellent to each other.